I'll just display the contents what we are going to cover for the next 5 days. So PostgreSQL Server developers contents are these are the contents. Okay, so there is we will start with the basic, that is introduction to PostgreSQL Server. So it consists of its features, it's the history, the architecture, all of these things, and installation part, everything, its hierarchy, all these things. So today we are mainly focusing on the theory. So what is PostgreSQL Server, how it started, what are the features, why PostgreSQL stands out from other databases, database servers, all those things. Okay, so and then later, so the procedural language and the dynamic SQL, the queries, okay, the types of queries. So how to access, you know, if you want any information from the database, how to access. So we will teach from the beginning. So from the select queries to DMD, structured query language to, okay, to the DML queries, all these things. And then designing and implementing databases tables. Okay, so today, once we, you know, complete the introduction to PostgreSQL Server, so later we'll do this today, that is implementing the databases and tables. Okay, so that involves the installation. Okay, so how to check the number of tables inside the databases, how to implement a database, how to create the database, how to create tables, how to check these metadata of the complete server, all these things. Okay, and ensuring the data integrity through constraints and the rules, working with indexes, how to create indexes, and what is full text search path. So all these things are we'll be covering in the day two. Later, partitioning, working with the triggers and rules and views. Okay, and working with transactions and error handling with the MVCC, and query optimization, how to increase the performance of a database, foreign data wrapper. It's a one good extra feature which we have added to the PostgreSQL Server. What is this foreign data server wrappers, and dealing with the large objects also we are going to learn in the last but 1 days, and communicating with the PostgreSQL using a library PQ also we are going to learn. And extensions. Okay, so what are these extensions? So why we need these extensions, and what is the advantage of this having these extensions? Okay, extension are nothing but the extra feature. Okay, so what and all extra feature that the Postgres has currently. So all these things we are going to learn in this 5 days of class. Okay, so today we are going to start with the introduction. Okay, so introduction is from the basic. So it's architecture, the features, its history. So all these things we are going to learn today. So let's start our class. Okay, so these are the PPTs. We'll fetch you later at the after once the class finishes, we'll fetch you this PPTs later to all your registered mail ID. Okay. So this is the PPT, and as a trainer, we will use our own document. Okay. So whatever the highlights of the PPTs are there, so those I'll just written over here. So this is also we'll be sending you. Okay. If you want to refer this, we'll be sending you this one also. Okay. So this is nothing but few extra things which are not there in PPT also. Okay. So now let's start. So what is Postgres? So Postgres is a database. Okay, it is a open, not only simply a database, it's a open source database. Okay, so whenever someone, you know, start to explain about Postgres, the first important feature which comes from, you know, which comes that this is the one main feature, which is Postgres is open source. What do you mean by open source? Open source is anyone from any location in the world, they can download and install, and they can use for their project without giving any cost. It's completely free of cost. That's why it is called open source. Okay. So it is open source RDBMS. RDBMS, we all know. Being a DBS, maybe some of you are not DBS as per someone told. So RDBMS, the full form of RDBMS is every database we call RDBMS. RDBMS is nothing but relational database management system. Okay, that is called RDBMS. Relational database management system. So why we call relational database management system? Because the data which we will store inside the database in terms of tables. Okay, so in database technology, we refer tables as relations also. Okay, we refer table as relations. Okay, so that's why database is also called relational database management system. Okay, so that's why Postgres is also called open source RDBMS. But it's not only simply RDBMS, we also refer this Postgres as object-oriented RDBMS. What is this object-oriented? So object-oriented is a concept you have, heard it from the C language. Okay, it's nothing but a OOPS concept. Okay, object-oriented. So what is this object-oriented? It's, okay, as I told, it's a concept from the C language. It's a programming language. Why we use this object-oriented concept here? Yes, there is a reason. Why? Because object orientation is nothing but every, object in the C language, it will be referred as a unique object ID. Okay, every procedure, every table, everything. Okay, so everything will be referred with a unique ID, its own object ID. Okay, so that's what it is, object oriented. So like that, in Postgres also, every table, every procedure, every trigger, or every database itself, it is referred with its own unique ID. Okay, or also it is called object ID. Okay, so that's why we sometimes Postgres we also call as object oriented RDBMS. Okay, it's open source ORDBMS. Okay, that's why Postgres also refer as object oriented RDBMS. RDBMS for relational database management system. Okay, so where we get the this information about the Postgres database? For example, if I want to download it, where I'll get? Okay, so for example, other databases like Oracle, MySQL, they have their own official website, oracle.com, mysql.com, right? So here, the official website of Postgres is postgresql.org. Okay, postgresql.org. So this is the official website of the Postgres database. Okay, so here only you will get, is there any updated packages are available? Okay, from the Postgres, if they release any new version patch, so everything will be available in this, in their official website called postgresql.org. Okay, now who owns it? So Postgres is not owned by one owner. Okay, so it is maintained by a bunch of developers. Okay, who only owns the Postgres? Okay, so there is no one owner and lakhs of people are working under him, nothing. So there is a bunch of developers who owns it and who are frequently working on database, this Postgres SQL database server. And if there is any if they want to do any upgradation, they will do on a timely basis and they will release the patch. Okay, this Postgres, the difference between other database servers and this one is it is open source. Okay, so that's why you won't get the dedicated employees who work from the support team. So that's why you won't get the support 24/7. Okay, because other servers like Oracle and others, if you raise any issue, people will come to help you because you have paid them, right, in order to use. But this is open source. So that's why the one disadvantage is you won't get the effective support from the Postgres database. You will get, but it's kind of slow. You have to go to this website there, they will mention, they, you know, mention the developer's name with their email ID. Okay, so there where you have to report your problem, or there will be some contact numbers also they will mention. So using that, you have to call. Okay, so it's not, you know, the, you don't get the, you know, 24/7 support from Postgres. Okay, why? Because it's not, you know, paid one. It is a post, you know, it's an open source Postgres database. So you haven't paid them, right? You haven't paid anything. That's why you won't get the effective support from them. Okay, but there is an option, but it's not that fast as other databases. Okay, so that's how, you know, it, you know, the Postgres database works. Okay, so since it is an open source, you won't get the support as easily as other databases. That's the one of the few, you know, disadvantage. Okay, there is a reason it, because it is open source. That's why it is how it, you know, it works. Okay, so later I want to know the journey of the Postgre database. So history, why the name Postgre, where, you know, how it came. So it all came by the professor who works in a University of California, okay, whose name is Michael Stonebreaker. He's the professor in the University of California. So what he did, so he was working on a data model. Okay, he was working in a data model, and so he started to write a source code, which is in the name of Ingress. Okay, he was writing the source code in the, just a minute. Sorry, team, there was a disturbance from my end. I just corrected it. So yeah, I was talking about the Michael Stonebreaker. Okay, he was working on a data model. For that, he was writing a source code. Okay, the source code name was Ingress. Okay, it all started with the Ingress. And later, which was in the 1980s, later in the 1990s, his bunch of students, okay, mainly the name Andrew, they have done some post-production activity on this data model and the, you know, the resource code which was written in an Ingress. Okay, so they have added the SQL language to it, okay, the metadata database and the query language as a Postgres SQL language. Okay, so all it all started with the Ingress language, and then his bunch of students did the post-production activity on this Ingress, and then they added SQL to it, and they made it a Postgre SQL. Okay, it all started in the year of 1995. Okay, it's almost 3 decades, and still also people are, you know, using Postgre SQL, and people are happy after using this Postgre SQL because it's a very powerful tool. Okay, so it gives all the features just like other databases give in terms of security, reliability, okay, flexibility, everything. So currently the running versions in the market is 13 version, 12 version. These are the 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay, there is, versions are available from 9.6. Okay, so below 9.6 is not available. So after 9.6 was also available. 9.6, 10, 11, 12 is also available, but mostly the highly running, the versions, you know, in the market is 12, 13, 14, and the 15 is the latest one. Okay, so this is the history of the Postgre database. Okay, this is how it started. This is how the name has come to the Postgre SQL database. Okay, so now why should we use it? Okay, so you have all come here to learn Postgres. That means the project is, you know, will maybe your project will be using this Postgre SQL server, you know, in the next project or your upcoming project. That's why you came here. So, but before, you know, you are, you know, coming here, you should learn, okay, before, you know, starting to learn about Postgres, you should learn what is the position of this Postgre SQL in the market. Okay, in the ranking of PostgreSQL database server, what is its position? Okay, so that's we have to learn. Is it, you know, is it maintaining a good position in the market? Okay, so that's you can, you know, easily, you know, get to know by just using the ranking system of RDBMS. That is nothing but the relational database system. So we should know what is the ranking of our Postgre. Okay. So before, you know, getting to know about its position in the respectable, you know, its position in the ranking. Okay. Oh, no. After that, we'll start to learn its feature. So now, if you see, these are the ranking system of all the database system. Okay. So there are paid one are there, open source are there, every kind of database models you can see here. The first one is Oracle, okay, which is a paid one. Second one is MySQL. Third one is Microsoft one, SQL Server. These are all paid one, okay. And the fourth one you can see our PostgreSQL, okay. So this is maintaining, you know, top fourth in the database technological rankings. Okay, so it is a top fourth. PostgreSQL database is maintaining a very respectable position in the ranking. So here only you can see, you know, where our Postgre database is standing. Okay, so this is one good example that you know it will inspire you to learn about the PostgreSQL server, right? So now we'll learn. Okay. Why it is maintaining, you know, such a highly, you know, respectable position in the ranking? Because you can see all these, you know, the databases which are above Postgres, below Postgres are all paid one. People are, you know, paying, you know, in thousands in, you know, to, you know, use all these databases. But Postgres is free of cost. Even though it is free of cost, it is maintaining this high position in the ranking. That means it has some outstanding features. Okay, and including all these Oracle database, MySQL, everything provides high security, right? So this one also is not compromising with those, you know, the features. Okay, so now we have to learn how this, you know, the PostgreSQL is maintaining the top fourth position. Okay, so now let's understand its outstanding features, and also it also tells why we have to use it. Okay, before learning it, first we should understand, okay, its features, its advantages, its disadvantage, everything. Later only we have to choose the database. So before the business owner choose the databases for his project, first he will check all these features, right? So now let's check the features of the PostgreSQL server. So first, for most important feature of PostgreSQL server is its flexibility. Okay, so no other database servers are as flexible as our PostgreSQL database. Okay, why? So there are so many reasons to support this point. Okay, so the first the point which supports is extension. So extension is one of the modules we are here. We are going to learn about extension. Okay, so extension, what is extension? As the name only tells, extension is nothing but the extra feature that you are going to add to the Postgre database. Okay, so extension is nothing but the extra feature that you are going to add to the Postgre database. So that means if the database called Oracle has one feature called DB Link. Okay, so DB Link is the feature which uses the Oracle. The DB Link is to link with the other databases, right? So, but that feature is not there in our Postgre database, okay? But the Postgre database is highly flexible such a way that you can, you know, use the source code of this DB Link, okay? And you can install in the PostgreSQL server. So that's the beauty of the Postgre database, okay? For example, that is one thing. Another one, foreign table. Oracle uses the foreign table to access the foreign data. So that was not there in our Postgre database. Okay, by default, the developers didn't develop it. But what they did is they added that as an extension. Okay, so extension is nothing but an extra feature. Okay, it's a set of code or program which can be activated in a Postgre database server. Okay, so currently developers have developed 48 extensions. Okay, so they have added 48 extensions, which are those are the features were not there in our database, Postgre database, but what they did was they have added as an extension. Okay, so currently 48 extensions are already available. So you no need to write the code and dog. You just have to activate it. You can use that, those extensions. Okay. So few examples for extensions are there. So for example, Ctext is also example for an extension. So where we are all going to learn this, about extension in the last class. Okay. So extension is one of the modules we are going to learn. So extension is a program or a set of code which can be activated. So this extension itself tells that Postgre is highly flexible. So this is an example which I gave for one of the extension. Anyhow, we are going to do it once again in the later class. Okay. So next, available for all the platforms and APIs. Okay. So this Postgre is not only dedicated for Linux platform or Windows or Mac. It is available for all the platform and all the APIs also. Okay. So you can use it for the Windows, you can use it for the Mac, you can use this Postgre database for the Linux platform also, okay? And if you want to write the procedural language, so it's not like only PGPL SQL is compatible with the database. No, if you are good at Python, you can write it in a Python language. If you are good at Perl, you can write it in a Perl language also. Okay, so that's how it supports these kind of languages in order to write the procedural language. So these many points which supports that Postgres is highly flexible, right? The first point is extensions. So extensions are nothing but the extra feature that you are going to add in the Postgres database. Currently, developers has added 48 available extensions. In the later, in the 15th version, you will see this many extension. In the 12th or 11th version, you can see only 42. So people are adding, the developers are currently working and adding few more extension. Okay, so Postgres database is highly the flexible such a way that you can add the feature of other databases. For example, this foreign table or DB link as an extension to the Postgre database. And then Postgre database is highly available for all the platforms. It's not like dedicated for one platform. It is available for all the platforms and APIs. And if you want to write any procedural language, you can use other than PLSQL, PLSQL. If you are good at Python language also, you can use your language in order to write the procedural language. And also, if you are good at Perl language also, you can write it in a Perl language. Next, it's lightweightness. So Postgre database server, if you will get to know while installation, okay? But you will get all the lags with the installing only. So I'll tell you how to install, okay? At that time, you will get to know. It will be done within, few minutes actually. Okay, that is only, that only shows that how Postgre database is, very easy to install and it is lightweightness. It's completely lightweight, okay? So in your laptop, if you want to install Oracle, at least it needs 8 GB of RAM, right? So it needs 8 GB of RAM. But our Postgre it's very lightweight and you can use, if you have less than 1 GB of RAM also, you can install the Postgre database. And if you have less than 2 GB of hard disk also, it is minimum. Okay, it is minimal. If you have this kind, much of hard disk and the RAM also, you can install the Postgre database server. Okay, so that shows that Postgre database is highly lightweight. Okay. So since it is a lightweight, it has this feature of lightweightness. So the applications like antivirus applications, for example, McAfee, so they use the database called embedded database. Okay. When they were using the database, those database we call embedded database. So they use this lightweightness of this, use this feature of lightweightness of the Postgre database as an advantage. Okay. Because they no need to use, more number of RAM and hard disk, right? So they will use the embedded database as a Postgres. Okay. Most of the antivirus applications use Postgres as a embedded database. So not only this, the very famous applications like Netflix, Instagram, Skype, all these are using the Postgre database itself. Okay. So currently the Postgres database is highly used by so many applications, which you might have heard of all these social media, this OTT platform, applications. These are all using the Postgre database. Next, reliability. So, no person will select the Postgre database, particular database as his database in order to use to his project just because it is an open source. Just because it is free of cost, he doesn't choose. He will mainly check the database, okay, about its reliability. Reliability means how reliable the database is. Okay. So even though some issues happen on the database, okay, which corrupt the original files of the database, we should have a backup for that. Okay. So clients won't ask for your reason. They want their database, always available 24/7, 365 days, right? They won't, listen the reasons of our data corruption and all, right? So that means it should be, database must be highly available, okay? So the high availability will depends on how reliable our database is, okay? So in order to make the database reliability, so it should have the features like, the redo logs, undo logs, archiving, the backups, all these things, or the replications. So these makes the database highly reliable. Okay. So these are nothing but the logs. So which help you to help the database such a way that if your original data, which are there in the data files gets lost also, we have a backup of those original files. Okay. For example, redo files. Okay. Archiving. It's nothing but a backup of the redo. Okay. And also we take a backup of our entire database by using the script. And also we have a replication, disaster management. For example, you have placed a server in some location. Okay. It's your data center, but some adverse situation occurs that flood has come to your city. Your entire data center got collapsed. At that time, your entire data got lost, right? So in order to avoid such situation, situation can't be avoided, like flood and all, or the building crash, this and all, we can't avoid. But what we can do is we can have a exact copy of your one data center and we can place in another place, which is far from your original location. So that's what we call replication, right? So replication is nothing but a replicating the original data center, so that if your original, the data center, your entire server only got crashed, at that time we should have a backup. So having the backup will increase the reliability of the database. Okay. And also inside server, one disk got corrupt also, we should have a backup of that data. So everything we have in our Postgre database. Okay. We are in Postgres, we don't compromise with the reliability. Okay. We have all the features which supports its reliability. We have the backup features, create an archiving features also. Okay. and disaster management, replication also, all these things we have. Okay. So redo, undo, these are all DBS stuffs. That is, redo is redoing the work, undo is saving the pre-modified data, archiving is saving the log into another disk, which is optional, backup and recovery. These are all DBS stuff, but it's better to know about it. Okay, so we have all these things. Okay, so if the original data got, you know, corrupted in the original data files also, we have redo logs, we have archive logs, and we do have backup and recovery features. Okay, using that, you can tell that you can recover the lost data, and also you can tell that Postgre database is highly reliable. Next is security. So Postgre database is highly secure, okay, in terms of encryption, in terms of user management. Okay, how we can secure the database? The most important thing is, what is the encryption algorithm our database is using, right? So if it is using the advanced encryption algorithm, which is nothing but, which is using the complicated password, okay? So this Postgre database is also using the advanced encryption algorithm, okay? So it is using the strong password, okay? So that the intruders cannot able to, you know, break that password and enter into the database, okay? So that will be not happen. So all because of it is using the advanced encryption algorithm. So it has a, you know, good user management and with a strong password, and also external authentication support is also available. So Postgres is highly secured. Next is cost effective. So cost effective, yes, we all get all these features with the no cost, right? So it's a wonderful thing. So you will get all these, you know, the features like flexibility features and high secure, high reliable, cost of the lightweightness, everything with the no cost. You no need to pay. So that's why it is called cost effective. But no business people will select the database as their database for their project just because it is cost effective. They will check how secure this database is, how reliable this database is, how secure, how flexible this database is. So after that only, they're gonna choose, right? So that's tell that Postgre database is highly secured, highly reliable, highly flexible, and we all get all these features with the less cost, which is completely cost effective. So these are the features of the Postgre database server, okay? So just want to make sure that even though it is open source, it is not compromised with these qualities, okay? So these are the features and the history of the Postgre database. Now